Hey, welcome back to PSDZ. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you some really cool techniques for changing the backgrounds in portrait photography. Not only that, I will also be sharing some masking blend tricks that will help you to seamlessly match the light and shadows of your subject to the new background. Before we get started, let's take a look at this photograph that we will be working with today. As you can see, it's just a normal boring photo that you could use a little bit of spursing up, but don't worry, with just few simple editing tricks, we can completely transform this photo and make it look absolutely awesome. If you want to follow along with me and edit this photo together, you can download the image using the links that I have provided in the video description. So let's dive in and get started on this exciting project. In this photo manipulation, the first and the most important step is to separate the subject from the background. This can be done using various selection tools available in Photoshop. Once you have selected the tool of your choice, you can simply click on Select Subject and let Photoshop do the job for you. In most cases, it does a perfect job in selecting the subject, making your work easier. Next, you need to go to Select and Mask to refine the selection. If you zoom in, you may notice that some tricky areas such as hair may not have been perfectly selected. Don't worry, just click on this Refine Hair button and it will fix the issue. Once you are satisfied, scroll down to the Output section and select Section as Output and click OK. Then press Ctrl or Command plus J to make a copy of the selection. Then rename this new layer as Subject. So now that we have the subject cut out, let's work on the background. Add a new layer by clicking on New Layer button at the bottom of the Layers panel. Then go to the Edit menu and select Fill. Choose Black as the fill color and click OK. Next, double click on the new layer to open the Layer Styles dialog box. In the Layer Styles menu, select Pattern Overlay. In Pattern Overlay dialog box, choose Dark Grain Background Pattern. I will provide a link for you to download this pattern for free, and you can check the description or pinned comment section. You can use this pattern in your own projects as well. By default, the pattern settings are good, but feel free to adjust them to your liking. Once you are done, click OK. And that's it for the background. Adding a spotlight effect to the background can be a great way to draw attention to the subject. We can do that using gradient adjustment. Go to Adjustments and select Gradient. From there, choose the White to Transparent Gradient option. In this particular task, the instruction is to change the blacks in the gradient editor to white. Once you have made this change, click the OK button in the gradient editor to confirm the modifications. Next, change the method to Classic. Classic produces a more predictable and uniform result by blending the gradient linearly across the layer. So that's why I always choose the Classic for the photo manipulations. And set the style to Radial. Once these options have been selected, click OK to apply. To ensure that the spotlight effect is applied to the background, drag the two gradient layers below the subject layer. At this point, it's also a good idea to rename these layers to keep things organized. Let's rename Layer 1 to Background and Gradient Fill 1 to Spotlight. While the spotlight effect can be striking, it may appear a little intense at first. To adjust the intensity, simply lower the opacity of the spotlight layer. In this case, an opacity of 65% looks good, but feel free to experiment with different values until you find the perfect balance. Alright, we are making some serious progress here. Let's move on to the next step to really make this backdrop stand out. Let's add a little bit of contrast. This can easily be achieved by going to the Adjustments panel and selecting Brightness and Contrast Adjustment. Now all you need to do is move the slider to the right hand side to increase the contrast. It's important to keep an eye on the image while you are doing this to ensure that you don't go overboard with the contrast. In this case, value of 60 looks good. So far, great job. Now add one more new layer. Go to Edit and select Fill. Choose White as the color to fill this layer with. Next, double click on this new layer. To bring up the Layer Styles options, choose Gradient Overlay. And select the Black to Transparent Gradient. Keep all the settings to default. But wait, make sure to change the method to classic. Once you have made this change, click OK to apply the gradient overlay. We are now at crucial stage of tutorial. We will be blending the subject and the background together with light and shadows. Right click on the layer and convert it to smart object. Next, go to filter and select distort. Then choose twirl. Keep the angle at 100 and then click OK. This will create a black and white layer, which we will use as a mask to match the colors, lighting, and shadows of the subject with the background. This is the most important part of the tutorial as it will make your effect look more natural and realistic. Now right click on the layer and rasterize it to complete the process. We are getting close to the end of this tutorial. Now go to image and select adjustments, then apply levels. In this menu, you can drag the highlight slider to make the bright areas brighter and adjust the gamma value to darken the midtones. This will help prepare the layer for use as a mask. Let's rename this layer to for mask so we can easily identify it later on. Next, turn on the subject layer and duplicate it. Add a layer mask to the duplicate layer, then go to image and select apply image. In this menu, choose the for mask layer and keep all other settings as they are. Click OK to apply image. Now double click on the layer mask to open the mask properties. Lower the density to around 70% and feather it slightly to soften the edges. At this point, you no longer need the fur mask layer. You can either delete it or hide it, whichever you prefer. In this case, I will just hide it. We will duplicate the subject copy layer again. Then we will select both subject copy layers and right click to select merge layers. By blending the subject and background together, you will be able to create an image that truly stands out. Let's rename this new layer Mask Blend. Now we want to convert this layer to a smart object. Next, we will go to Image, Adjustments, select Highlights and Shadows. In this panel, we can adjust the highlights and shadows to fit our image requirements. For this image, I will increase the adjustments in the midtones to give it a more natural look. Once you have made your adjustments, click OK to apply the changes. For our final step, we will add a dark green effect to the overall photo, which adds some depth and texture. Select the background layer and duplicate it. Move the new layer to the top. Then right click on the layer and convert it to smart object. Right click again and select rasterize layer. Rename this layer to dark green. Now go to filter, other, high pass filter. Keep the radius at 10 pixels and click OK. Change the layer blending to overlay and you are done. Now to improve the image further, we can add some final touch-ups to make it look more polished. To get rid of the white fringing, we can open the spotlight layer and move it slightly higher to cover the edges of the subject's hair. Next, select all the layers and press Ctrl or Command plus G to group them together. Name this group effect so that we can easily find it. If you notice, there are some skin imperfections on the face. You can add skin smoothing filter to make it look more flawless. You can also use the healing brush tool or clone stamp tool to remove blemishes and wrinkles. Finally, to add some color tone to the image, you can use the color lookup adjustment layer. Choose a preset that fits the mood of the photo or adjust the settings to your liking. And there you have it. Here is the before and here is the after. With a few simple steps, you have transformed an ordinary photo into a stunning work of art. Keep experimenting with different techniques to keep your photo editing skills to the next level. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you enjoyed this tutorial and want to see more like it, please consider subscribing to our channel. By subscribing, you will be notified when we release new tutorials and content. I am always working on new videos, so be sure to stay tuned for our next one. Until next time, take care.